Chairman Ghannouchi, how is the transition to democracy going?
I have to be optimist. We haven't another choice only to let this experience of democratize our country and our Arab world succeed. Since 19th century, the Muslim world has a dream. The dream is how we can coexist, conciliate democracy and Islam, or modernity with Islam. This dream has not succeeded because the outside pressure, the colonization, has crushed this dream. I think this the Arab Spring now give the opportunity to this dream to emerge. And in the first time in our history in Tunisia, we had free and honest elections. Now we have an assembly, real assembly. We have elected government. We have elected president. So we are now in the way to achieve the second goal of our revolution. The first one is to implement a democratic system. Now the second goal, we started to go to this, the second is to develop our country, to implement a real development in the country. I well, think we are in good way to achieve our goals.
I want to talk more about this link between expectations and trust and effective democracy, but immediately the question of economics comes up. How is your ability to deliver economically to the people of Tunisia coming so far?
It's true that guaranteed the main the process of free elections is not enough to achieve the democracy. Democracy needs civil society, rich, very rich civil society, needs also to respond to the main necessity of the people, because democracy without social justice can be transformed into mafia. The government can be transformed into sort of mafia, so we have guaranteed the needs of people, social justice, and people can achieve these needs when we open up the system, when we have free economy, when we fight against the corruption, because the governments, not in Arab world, but in many, many countries, is transformed into mafia. We have to fight against the corruption. We have to open up the system to attract the investors, the investment from inside and from outside, and to guarantee the social justice.
Chairman Ghannouchi, do you feel that the democratic world has let down the Arab Spring?
I think that the Arab Spring is very important for all the world, because the Arab world is very, very important as a base of the main wealth, the petrol, the strategical place. I think if the democracy can succeed in this part of the world, I think it will be in favor of the whole of the world. I think some Orientalists argue many times that Islam is obstacle in face of democracy. The Arab Spring proved that Islam is element of democratize this part of the world. and all the mainstream of the Islamic movement, like Ikhwan Muslimin in Egypt, Nahda in Tunisia, Justice and Liberty in Morocco, in Turkey. The mainstream of Islamic movement is moderate one. They decide, they believe that democracy and Islam, modernity and Islam is compatible. So the world have good benefit from what happened in Arabic world through the Arab Spring.
Mike, could we specifically ask Chairman Ghannouchi about Syria as a part of this, which is what Ken is raising? Because I think that there obviously is a question here as to whether or not the Western world has in fact been supportive of the expansion of the Arab Spring, including into Syria. And I think that's the
After the collapse of the Soviet Union, the wave of democracy was spread in the world except the Arab world. I think the obstacle was not Islam, but the outside pressure, which doesn't help the democracy in Arab world. I think now this wave of democracy will spread through all Arabic countries, among them Syria. I have any doubt that Syria revolution will be succeed as all other revolutions.
Chairman Ghannouchi, if you had to rank, though, the importance of social media in the Arab Spring versus the importance of Al Jazeera, yes, what would you say?
The Arab Spring is made in part by the media, but not the traditional media, by the new media, by Facebook, Twitter. I convey my salam to the people of Facebook and Twitter because they share, they participate very strongly in doing this revolution. So it's true that some channel like Jazeera sharing this revolution, but I think the new media, internet, Facebook, Twitter, as the leader and of this revolution.
But George Soros was here the other day, and he basically compared your party to the Christian Democrats here in Europe. Is that a reasonable analogy?
Yes, it's reasonable. Because cutting off the politics from the values, from the spirit, means we'll end by transforming the state and the economy as mafia, as I said. So we have to let moral play a role in the economy, in the game of democracy, instead of push things toward a war without any restrictions, without any values. So I think what Mr. Soros said is true. There is many commons between the Christian Democrat and the Islamic movement Democrat.
Why do you think Islam is so misunderstood?
In Islam, there isn't any sort of church. So no spokesman of Quran. Any Muslim can learn the Quran and understand what you understand. So within Islam, usually in the history, there is pluralism. Means free interpretation. Free interpretation means plurality. There is no spokesman of God in the earth. The Ummah, the nation, the whole Muslim nation is the spokesman of God. But no state, no church, no Islamic party can pretend that he is the spokesman of God. So democracy can goes with friendly, can work friendly with Islam, because we need in Islam we need democracy to make decision, because there are many interpretation of Islam. Which one we can decide that this one is good and we have implemented? The majority of Ummah, the ijma', consensus of Muslim, who can decide which Islam we choose to implement. But the after that, all Muslim can deal with the Quran, with the Sunnah, without any restrictions.
Seventh is the reason that Islam is misunderstood, and everything that relates to that, taking that action in the name of Allah, is what played a tremendous role in sending this horribly negative message about Islam throughout the world.
Chairman Ganesh.
Terrorism is against Islam, and the Muslim Ummah pay very, very negative price from this terrorism. I think linking Islam with terrorism is very bad. It's giving the terrorism a justification, because nothing common between what happened in 11th of September in Britain, in Tunisia, in everywhere. I think it's very negative, and giving justification for the terrorism. Nothing common between Islam, between jihad, the notion of jihad in Islam, and what the terrorists have done. And it's misunderstanding. In Europe itself, during 70s, there are some fractions who using violence. Left from the left and from the right, but how Europe can contain its extremists? It's through democracy.